Art, we could say, articulates lived experience. As one of the main philosophers of phenomenology, the French thinker François Merleau-Ponty once put it, true philosophy, by which he means phenomenology, is like art. It consists in relearning to look at the world. And then he also added, philosophy is not a reflection of a pre-existing truth, but, like art, the act of bringing truth into being. As a philosopher, I would like to look afresh at some of the ways we tend to speak about art and see whether those ways are still bearing fruit. And that implies looking at some of our beloved and well-used phrases, including terms such as creativity, beauty, and transcendence. I wonder whether we may have to be weaned off those terms a little bit. One problem, for example, with the term creativity is that it is not confined to the arts, but extends well beyond that into science and technology, management and business. So if you want to say anything more substantial about creativity as far as the arts go, we will have to be a bit more specific. So rather than saying that the purpose of art is to make an object of beauty, we could say its main purpose is to articulate lived experience, which may have beauty as a byproduct. Art teaches us to see. It teaches us to see, sense, and perceive nuances and beauty in moods in objects, landscapes, and anything we may set our eyes upon. Two, art alongside science or even religion is one way of making sense of the world, to create meanings. And that's what makes us different from animals. They don't reflect on the world in the same way. Three, art enables us to capture pre-reflective, lived experience. There it is again, which would otherwise go unnoticed as it operates under the radar screen of our conscious awareness. Four, art feeds the imagination. It allows us to envisage other worlds and possibilities, which in turn nurtures our capacity for hope, to believe in things and unseen and unimagined. And finally, five, and you need imagination for that, is art nurtures empathy and compassion, the ability to enter into someone else's mind and feelings with a view to being a good neighbor